COVID-19 has exacerbated inequalities both between and within countries. The poorest and most marginalized have been hit hardest, both in terms of lives and livelihoods lost. In the year ahead, says WHO's Director General, Dr. Tedros Ghebreyesus, the world needs to make 5 vital changes towards ensuring health equity among nations. At the top of the list is the need to invest in equitable production and access to COVID-19 rapid tests, oxygen, treatments, and vaccines between and within countries.
COVAX itself has already delivered 36 million doses to 86 countries and economies. Supply chains are up and running and health systems primed. Scaling up production and equitable distribution remains the major barrier to ending the acute stage of this pandemic. It is a travesty that in some countries, health workers and those at risk groups remain completely unvaccinated. The effort to achieve vaccine equity will not stop this week. WHO will continue to call on governments to share vaccine doses and fill the $22.1 billion gap in the ACT accelerator for the equitable distribution of vaccines, rapid tests, and therapeutics.
Prime Minister of Barbados, Mia Mottley, has embraced this first call made by the WHO's Director General for equity in the COVID crisis. For the small island developing states of the region, she says the past year has been a torturous journey.
The bald reality is that our market size in many instances is simply too small to command the attention of global pharmaceutical companies or indeed of other suppliers of goods in the normal supply chain that will lead for therapeutics distribution, vaccine distribution. And the bottom line is that we have also separately been regarded by the global community as countries that have come out of the depths of poverty and therefore are not deserving of assistance in the traditional ways normally reserved for the most vulnerable. This has made life difficult. We've held on to the promise of COVAX, and I've come to you this morning having received the first tranche of Barbados's vaccines, 3% of our population, with respect to the COVID vaccines this morning. But for many globally, this has been a difficult exercise because as we've seen, the spikes can literally grow. We've not had access even when we are prepared to pay.
Other changes suggested by the WHO's Director General to achieving health equity among nations of the world include serious investment in primary health care, prioritizing health and social protection, building safe, healthy, and inclusive neighborhoods, and enhancing data and health information systems. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.